set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled at the 36. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. The middle. That'll make it second and four. Ball on their own 42. And down he goes
at about the 49.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
It's a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
From the 34-yard line, first down. They'll work the left side. Tackle at the 25-yard line. And he is drilled at the 24. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
They get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it second and six.
From the 20-yard line, second down. Pretty good defense there on the option. They'll stop him for a loss of one. And this play is number 8 on the drive. He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down around the 9-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And it pays off. Touchdown. Into the end zone.
Hey, for this guy, it doesn't matter how it's drawn up. He can make his own play as he goes along. That was a nice run.
He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 63-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 7-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Gets it. He's in space. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Taken down in the backfield.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 50. From midfield, it's first down. He makes it to the 48-yard line. Gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third down again. Gets it out quickly. And they make the stop around the 33-yard line. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Throw's complete, he stopped immediately. It's the ninth play of the drive.
Cut it left, cut it left. Three down.
Aiden's getting the ball.
On play action, throws, end zone. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 64-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. We get a tie game at 7-7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's taken down to the 38-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Got it complete, and he's out of bounds.
This is why it's so important to have success in running the football. It forces a defense to prepare for it, and then that creates chances on play action. They executed that one perfectly.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. On the ground, up the middle. Tackle made right around the 44-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33. We've played one quarter. We're even at 7 in this one. even first quarter as we head into quarter number two. To the right, tackled for a loss.
I think the corner is the toughest position to play in football. You have to be athletic enough to be able to run with wide receivers and willing to be able to come up and make plays like this to be able to stop the run. This is a big time play by a corner, showing the versatility to be able to come up and be physical in the run game.
Throws it in a hurry. He's out of bounds around the 31 yard line.
Bring up third and eight.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 23. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Fires to the wideout, first down. Change your quarterback, Kirby. Got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy. Incomplete. That one sailed on him.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 21. He's tackled at about the 11. This is the ninth play of this drive. Move to finish it off. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A nice 9-play, 62-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Tackle at the 37-yard line.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense can continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Decent run here, right side. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Little handoff. So the halfback gets some decent yards and a first down.
He took advantage of a powerful effort by his offensive line to turn that into a pretty big run.
And they'll run him again. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
It's second and 5 here. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's taken down at the 44-yard line.
No gain. That'll make it
35. Hold this.
Mike four.
Got a man. Watch out here. That's a great tackle at the 32.
I'm not sure if the back was his first option, but he got him the ball, and he was able to make something big happen.
From the 32-yard line, first down. He's at the 20, makes it out to about the 13.
First down.
Mike four.
gets it out to about the 11-yard line. He holds on to it and gets maybe 2 yards. This is the eighth play of this drive. The offense calls a timeout. Gets to about the 11-yard line. And here's another third down. Finds the tight end for a touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 63-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result. 14 apiece. They line up to kick this one away. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. Both these defensive coordinators have got to be going crazy right now. We've had 4 straight possessions in which these offenses have put points on the board. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Slings it to his tight end, but he drops it. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32. Strike to his receiver, no good.
The pass ball's incomplete. Number one was the intended receiver on the play. That brings us 3rd and 10.
They'll make the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
And that'll be 3 and out. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
That's the kind of play calling and execution I like to see. Being one-dimensional on first down can really stack the odds against you. It's better to mix it up.
1st and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. There's a strike complete. He's down. And down he goes at about the 19-yard line. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. And they got him.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. Trying to take the lead by a field goal. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. 17-14.
Hi, Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And, boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
But, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this grave. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Here's the halfback. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They come out on an empty backfield. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
Rid of this one.
Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
Got the corner. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. Oh, man. He took him down hard.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Caught with room to work. Brought down at the 32-yard line.
First and 10. Ball on the 32.
He's at the 20. Gets out to around the 9.
Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Feeds it to the back. The running back gets two on the carry.
This junior corner's been progressively improving his run defense. He's better at diagnosing those plays now, and he knows how to bring a guy down.
Gives it to the back. Tackle
right around the 4-yard line.
The back gets three on the carry. Third and goal, and they can already taste the lead.
This defense not wanting to give an inch here.
And he's tackled at the 3. A 1-yard gain by the halfback. Kicks away,
and the field goal is good.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He got hit hard.
You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Run, right side. Nice run there as they work the outside.
Gaining 5 yards. That brings him second and five.
From their own 41-yard line. Second down. Whiteout makes the first down catch. They'll bring him down at the 49-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
From the 36-yard line, it's first down. And he has it on the corner. Lost the ball. Fumble. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Gets to about the 34-yard line.
Second and nine.
Double tight, guys. Double from their own 34-yard line. Second down. Quick shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. And they make the stop around the 48-yard line. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 48-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 49.
That makes it second and 10.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
So we're looking at another third down here. They'll spread the field with five wide. Quick strike to the receiver. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. Too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. They coughed up the pigskin the last time they had the ball. Let's see if they can hold on to it this time.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Run inside. Stop quickly. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 20. And he just gets rid of it.
catch. So at the end of three, good game here, 17-17. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Made at about the 49. That's good for the first down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49. They bring him down. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Nice run, and he's brought down. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They go with a run, and he's taken down behind the line. Loss of one there for the halfback. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Makes his way to about the 22. That makes it first and 10. From the 22-yard line, first down. Under pressure. Quick throw, almost intercepted. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. And a quick throw. And he's taken down around the 14-yard line. The defense gets their fourth chance to make a stop here on third down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He gets out to about the 12-yard line. This is the 14th play of this drive. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Left, picked off. Sheds that one. What a crucial interception, and that'll change the whole landscape of this game.
And now is the time to take advantage. This offense still has a job to do. They need to put points on the board to break this tie. But wow, do we have a great game or what?
From their own 8-yard line, first down. Open field, and down he goes around the 15-yard line. They come out in a five-wide set. Gets it out quickly. He gets hit out of bounds around the 24-yard line. From their own 24-yard line, it's first down. Looks for his running back, incomplete.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Gets it. He's in space. Brought down right around the 38-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 38. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Slings it. About 6 yards on that completion.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's got another one. Tackle around the 38-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Just throws this one away. From the 38-yard line, second down. He's tackled around the 29-yard line. He throws it. Big play, and it's first and goal. The offense calls a timeout, and that was their first timeout. Tied up here in the fourth. Now would be the time for a goal line stand. They'll bring him down around the 3-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
And that was the junior corner who'll get credit with that tackle.
This is the 13th play of this drive. The kick is up. Yes, he made it, and this one is over. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's out to the 30. Gets out to about the 31. Game's over, and our final score in this one, the Unicorns 20, the Sharks 17. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.